Everyone, it's TJ, the Stereo Barbet Fowl, and I am very excited today, you all, to bring you part two of my straight-up review of the ELAC UB52s, which is basically a three-way bass reflex designed stand-mount speaker, passive stand-mount speaker. Now, today, during part two, I'm going to go over amplifier pairing with the ELAC UB52s, and I want to take you all for a deeper dive inside of the speaker cabinet, so I can show you all the internal bracing, the crossover, and give you a closer look at all the drivers as well. But first, let's talk about amplification. Now, one thing I want to tell you all from the very beginning of this video is that I have over a dozen amplifiers, but all of my amplifiers are Class AB amplifiers. And one of the first things that I noticed with the ELAC UB52s is they do like power. And I wanted to just give you a quick example of that today. Here in front of me, I have the IOTA VX SA3 integrated amp here on top. That is rated at 50 watts at 8 ohms and 90 watts at 4 ohms. Down below that, I have the Audiolab 6000A, which is an integrated amplifier rated at 50 watts at 8 ohms and 75 watts at 4 ohms. Now, the IOTA here on top, it weighs 14.5 pounds Class AB amplifier, or 6.5 kilograms. Down below, the Audiolab 6000A is a Class AB amplifier that weighs 17.2 pounds, or 7.8 kilograms. Now, both of these smaller integrated amps, in my opinion, just, they will push, the ELAC UB52s to have sound, but neither one of them have enough power to drive the ELAC UB52s properly. The ELAC UB52s do like power. Now, one of the giveaways to me before I bought the ELAC UB52s, I knew that they like power. And one of the reasons why is because ELAC has their powered speaker make something like the ELAC UB52s that they're ELAC calls the ARB51s, and that is their powered speaker. And with that powered speaker, ELAC is using 300 watts of power to drive their ARB51. Now, the actual bass woofer in the ARB51 is something like, with the ELAC UB52, which is the passive version. But anyways, ELAC uses a 160-watt Class D bash amplifier to drive the bass woofer in that powered speaker, the ARB51. And they also use a 100-watt Class D bash amplifier to drive the mid-range driver. And to drive the tweeter on the ELAC ABR51s, ELAC uses a dedicated 40-watt Class AB amplifier. So, after I read up on them speakers, before I even bought the UB52s, I knew they were going to like power. So I knew that I had to start, with my amplifiers all being Class AB design, I knew I had to start using, some more heavyweight amplifiers to get that full flesh and body sound in a two-channel stereo setup, to get it, to sound properly. So anyways, I picked out four amplifiers that actually had good to great synergy with the ELAC UB52s. Now, my first one is a budget, would be considered a budget setup. So let me get that out here for you all. Let's move the Audiolab and the IOTA. And here we have what I call my Emotiva combo. Now, this is basically the Emotiva BassX combo, the PT100 preamp, and down below we have the Emotiva BassX A300 power amplifier. Now, that power amplifier is rated at 150 watts at 8 ohms and 300 watts at 4 ohms. It does have some good power for its price point. Now, back when I done the review of the Emotiva combo, I called it solid state muscle on a budget. And that is exactly what it is, because it had no problem at all driving the ELAC UB52s. Yes, the Emotiva combo, I would consider it to be on the cool side of neutral. And the top end does have a little bit, of a, how would I call it? The top end has a little bit of a boost up top. It is lively up top, which really paired up good with the ELAC UB52s. Like I was telling you all in part one of the review, you know, the overall sound character of the ELAC UB52, in my opinion, you know, it has that nice and easy and that soft presentation to it. It's more of a gentle sounding speaker. So as soon as I hooked up the Emotiva combo, I tell you, I was smiling ear to ear, especially for its price point. And then, you know, I kept rolling, you know, more of my amplifiers because I wanted to find another amplifier that could drive the ELAC UB52s, you know, that didn't cost a lot of money but could drive them properly. Now, down here below with the Emotiva Basex A300 amplifier, I think it weighs 25.2 pounds or 11.4 kilograms. So one thing I was starting to notice with my Class AB amplifiers was that amplifiers, you know, Class AB that weigh like 25 pounds and above, I'm not really going by wattage. Again, how many watts an amplifier doesn't matter. It's the quality of them watts that matters. So to me, you know, I was thinking, you know, most of my amplifiers that were 24 and 25 pounds and heavier that are Class AB were really starting to drive the ELAC UB52s very well. But my amplifiers that weighed under 20 pounds that were Class AB, they really did struggle driving the ELAC UB52s. So now for my number two pick to drive the ELAC UB52s, my number two pick amplifier is no other, and I was really happy to see this, is my integrated amplifier, my Yamaha CA810. Now this Yamaha is from 1978. When it first came out, it was $475 US. In today's money, that would be about $1,500 US. But the Yamaha CA810 was rated at 65 vintage watts. Now, this amplifier was actually tested out on another YouTuber's channel, which is X-Ray Tony B. He's a guy that started a channel where, you know, he fixes and restores vintage audio gear. But when he tested out the Yamaha CA810, he tested it all the way up to 80 watts and holding at 0.05 THD, threshold distortion level. But anyways, you know, the Yamaha CA810 comes in weighing 27.5 pounds or 12.5 kilograms. But anyways, this integrated amplifier had no problems at all driving the ELAC UB52s. One thing about the Yamaha CA810 is, you know, those top-end frequencies are extended. You do have a lot of tone controls in the front, but, you know, most of the time, I keep all the tone controls on defeat or zero. But anyways, this vintage amplifier had no problem at all driving the ELAC UB52s. They had good synergy together. So now I'm going to talk about an entry-level amplifier that paired up good with the ELAC UB52s, and that will be number three amplifier pairing. Goodness. Now this one's going to be kind of tough to pick up, you all. I might have to do this one at a time. Okay, here we have it. My little Shit Fighter 2-channel amplifier. I'm actually going to set it up here. Now the 2-channel Vidar amplifier, I think it actually comes in around 22 pounds, and I actually just got this in. This is the Shit Freya Plus tube valve pre-amplifier. Now the Shit Vidar amp is rated 100 watts at 8 ohms and 200 watts at 4 ohms. Now when I hooked them up to the ELAC UB52s, I will tell you straight up, being a 22 pound Class AB amplifier, it really tested, you know, this Shit Vidar out. But the Shit Vidar comes with a big 600 VA L transformer, and 40,000 microfarad capacitance. And it was about the smallest Class AB amplifier that I had, you know, that I would actually use with the ELAC UB52s. I mean, it was just the right amount of power. But one thing that was really funny, you know, about, you know, having good synergy with what I would call, I guess, the shit combo, the shit Freya Plus and the Vidar, is one thing that I really enjoyed was that I could, it has three different modes. You have passive mode with the Freya Plus, you have JFET mode, and you can use the tubes also. But the overall, you know, sound character, it has this little grittiness, you know, extended grittiness in the top end that really brought some good life into the ELAC UB52s. Now, I will tell you, the Vidar amp, you know, isn't going to drive the ELAC UB52s properly at very loud levels, but from low listening levels to moderately loud listening levels, the Vidar had no problem in doing that. But what I'm trying to get to with you all is, you know, the heavier weight Class AB amplifiers I was using with the ELAC UB52s, the easier they are to drive. Now, my number one amplifier that I hooked up to the ELAC UB52s, well, it's number four, but overall, it actually had great synergy. All the amplifiers I just showed you all had good synergy. But I want to talk about the amplifier that had great synergy. Now, the only thing is, you all, that amplifier is in my reference room over here on your all's right-hand side, and it weighs 52 pounds, and I don't want to pick it up and have to bring it over here and show you all. If you've been watching this channel, you may even know what I'm already talking about. And yes, I am talking about my Yamaha AS1100, which is basically a two-channel pure analog integrated amplifier. Now, that amplifier does come in at $2,500 US, and I wouldn't recommend, you know, a $2,500 amplifier to drive a $599 US speaker. But let me tell you all, when I hooked the Yamaha AS1100 up to the ELAC UB52s, my jaw about hit the ground. I mean, the Yamaha just took complete control of the ELAC UB52s and drove it so easily. I was so impressed that, you know, I know it kind of sounds crazy to y'all, but it actually took a $600 speaker. It made it sound like a $1,000 speaker, but it took a $2,500 amplifier to get it there. So, I don't know, y'all. I know that might be pretty funny to y'all, whatever it is to me also. But, you know, for a long time, I was thinking, yeah, the Yamaha really tamed the ELAC UB52s. But the truth is, you all, the ELAC UB52s tamed my Yamaha AS1100. One thing about the Yamaha AS1100, one of the only caveats with it is sometimes, you know, the upper mid-range and the lower treble, it can have a little bit of hardness to it, or what I would call a bite to it. But, you know, the ELAC UB52s having that, you know, that nice and soft and easy and gentle overall sound character to it, the ELACs tamed my Yamaha AS1100. I mean, I would love to see how the tower versions of the ELAC UB52s, I can't remember the name, but I would love to see how they pair up with the Yamaha AS1100. But overall, you know, rolling all my Class AB amplifiers with the ELAC UB52s, one thing I did notice overall, you all, is that the ELAC UB52s, they do like an amplifier that has good power, and they actually will sound good, you know, with amplifiers on the cool side of neutral to, you know, neutral to just barely, just a hint of warmth in an amplifier. So that was kind of a really wide range area for me that these speakers were sounding good on. But one of the most important things was that these speakers do like power, especially if you're using Class AB amplifiers. I mean, I'm not a huge fan of Class D, but anyways, if you do have a Class D amplifier, then you may want to check out the ELAC UB52s, because I know there's Class D amplifiers out there that are very powerful, and they will drive these ELACs pretty easily. So this may be one of the one cases that I would say, hey, the ELAC UV52s, I would probably recommend a Class D amplifier with them, but the right Class D amplifier. And since I don't have any to test out, I can't speak on any. But anyways, that pretty much wraps it up for me with the amplifier pairing with the ELAC UV52s. Again, these speakers like power. They like an amplifier that does have a little bit extension on top. They will, you know, kind of what I would call, it would pretty much tame, you know, even amplifiers that can be overly lively. These speakers will tame it. They did it to my Yamaha AS1100. That was one of my favorite pairings with the ELAC UV52s. I mean, the Motiva done a great job combo. My vintage Yamaha CA810 done a good job. And the Shit Freya Plus and Vidar. That was part of the least powerful amplifier that was Class AB that I have that I would recommend with the ELAC UV52s. So now, let's take a deeper dive inside the ELAC UV52s speaker cabinet. And again, my number one pairing amplifier that sounded best with the ELAC UV52s was actually my 52-pound integrated amp, my Yamaha AS1100. So now, let's take a deeper dive inside of the ELAC UV52s. The one thing that is really cool about the speaker cabinet, you all, is that ELAC actually up here where the mid-range driver and tweeter go, it is actually its own cabinet. So I'm going to take out all this filling and give you all a closer look. As you can see on top, here's the insulation I took inside the mid-range driver and tweeter's own cabinet. It is completely sealed and separate from the rest of the cabinet. As you can see, we have our two different speaker cables coming in, one for the tweeter and one for the mid-range driver. We'll go inside a little bit. You can see all the glue and all the bracing inside. We'll go to the other side. I want to give you all a good view, more bracing, but I think that was a pretty cool design. Now let's go in the bottom, but up first I'm going to go ahead and take out this acoustic filling also. So here's the white acoustic filling I took out of each side. As you can see, this bottom cabinet back here, we do have a divider. So let's go in for a closer look. I'm going to try to keep it straight for you all. Here we have our port. And there's the divider. I think that goes all the way up. Nope, it's just a divider brace. Let me get that in good for you all. I want you all to see this brace. I will tell you, this speaker cabinet is very well grounded. Very well grounded. But to show you all that crossover, I'm going to have to flip it upside down. Okay, you all, let's dive in and look at the crossover. I will hold it as still as I can. I had to flip the speaker up, as you all can see. And we'll go in at an angle. I will tell you, I believe the majority of the money to build this speaker actually went into this crossover. This is a big crossover in here. Look at that, you all. That is a very well-built crossover for the price point of the ELAC UV52s. One of the most impressive I have seen at this price point. Very good job by Andrew Jones. And the crossover is very impressive, y'all, for price point. Hate to keep saying that over and over. Then above it, we have that little divider, that brace, which I think was a great idea also. We go up. You can see at the back of the crossover. But anyway, that was pretty cool. Now, let's check out the actual drivers of the ELAC UV52. So first, let's take a good look at this concentric driver. Again, we have a 4-inch mid-range aluminum cone. And in the middle, we have the 1-inch soft dome tweeter. Now, I was told by somebody that ELAC used neodymium magnets on the back. As you see back here, these actual posts here actually go down to the actual mid-range. I actually had to pick this up to show you all. It's where the mid-range driver connects. And then we look up here on top of the magnet. Right here is our tweeter. We can see the positive cable. And over on the other side, the ground. And it's running in behind here to hook up to the actual tweeter. It's got some good weight to it. So now, let's take a look at the 5 1/4-inch bass woofer. So here we have the 5 1/4-inch aluminum cone bass woofer. And it's got some really good weight. This is supposed to have the neodymium magnets also. And I can tell you, this magnet has a lot of weight, you all. Got a really nice size voice coil. It is a really, here you go, here's a better look at that voice coil. And we look here on the bottom, here's where we would plug it up. And if you look here on the bottom, you can see that we actually have a hole that goes all the way through the magnet. And I can see the aluminum cone on the other side. Now what this is a cooling port for the actual voice coil. So if you're really rocking this speaker out really good, you know, that's going to help it stay cool. That is a pretty cool design. And here we have our 5-way binding post. Probably one of the upgrades I will do to the speaker, because it was pretty tough to get inside of the speaker cabinet. I'll try to go over that real quick, but here's the other side. I would really like to get a hold of GNR Research and get me some tube connectors to put in here. I think it'd be very simple to do. And this was really easy to take off, just 4 screws, but getting inside the speaker cabinet. And here's the front ring that I had to take off to be able to take the bass woofer and the tweeter and mid-range driver off. This was very tough to take off the front baffle. On the other side, there is like 9 little alignment pegs, and all of them were like super glued down. The only way I could get into this speaker cabinet without breaking this was actually I took the speaker into my bathroom. I put a heater inside of my bathroom, far away from the speaker, of course. I got about 120 degrees inside of my bathroom, and I took just a little bitty screwdriver and easily, using a paper towel on the other side so I didn't damage it, I had to easily pry this off. It was very hard to get that off. It took me over an hour. But one thing I did notice about the 5-way binding post, here I have a very strong magnet. As you can see, they are not magnetic. But I would like to use some tube connectors in this from GNR Research. But that pretty much wraps it up for me today, you all. I'll give you just a real quick music listening with the Yamaha AS1100 to end this part 2 straight up video review of the ELAC UB52s. I've had a lot of fun with these speakers. No, they're not to my taste, but the speakers are growing on me. Last but not least, here are the cover grills. I would have really liked to have seen these been magnetic, but for its price point, I guess it's alright, but it is 2021. Now for a quick sound demo, real quick, about 10 seconds for you all. I will be recording this from my cell phone, so the audio quality won't be the best. This is just for fun. We'll be right back. stereo bargain file.
Red Riders of the Dark, help me through.